नमस्कार एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल लर्न एचटीएमएल विद नंदू जाधव एंड टुडेज आवर टॉपिक इज ऑडियोज ऑन अ वेब पेज। इन दिस टॉपिक वी विल डिस्कस हू ऑडियो फाइल्स आर प्लेड ऑन अ वेब पेज। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। सो ऑडियोज ऑन अ वेब फ्रेंड्स, एज लाइक इमेजेस द ऑडियोज आर ऑल्सो यूजफुल टू प्रेजेंट आवर इन्फॉर्मेशन वेरी मीनिंगफुली shortly and attractively to the cyber surfer. Such like images, the audio files which you want to play on a web pages must be in a standard format. And standard format means the audio file formats which are supported by all popular web browsers. Here some common, important, popular and standard audio file formats are: first one, that is the MP3, that is the Media Player 3, we can say, and this stands for MPG Audio Layer 3. This MP3 file sound quality is good, very good, and is developed by Moving Picture Experts Group. Okay, so this one is the first one, that is the .mp3. The another one is .aac, and this AAC stands for Advanced Audio Coding. This .aac audio file format is also very popular, and the sound quality of this audio file format is also very good as compared to MP3 file format. Especially this audio file format is standard for iPhone as well as YouTube. The next one, that is the third one, .ogg. This OGG file format's feature is first one, that is a free, that is the open source file format, and is developed by zip.org foundation. It is similar to the first one, that .mp3 file format, but the when you compare the sound quality of OGG with MP3, then .ogg is best as compared to MP3 file format. Okay, as well as this .ogg file format give metadata. Metadata means it gives extra information regarding the audio file, as well as the audio file's artist information, the track information contains in a metadata. So this is the best feature of the OGG. So these are the common three audio file formats which are supported by today's popular web browsers. So next one, we will see the how we can include or we can play audio file format or audio files on a web page. HTML 5.0 provide this audio tag to play audio file on our web page. This audio tag is a paired tag and its closing is compulsory. If we see the attributes, the first attribute of audio tag is SRC. SRC means source, and this SRC attribute specifies the URL of audio file which you want to play on a web page. If you see the syntax, then the syntax is simple, that the audio space SRC equal to URL of audio file which you want to play. This URL or this source value can be given in form of absolute value or in form of relative value. If we see the example here, this page plays audio file with form with controls here, and this one when you click here on a play button, then it start playing the music. Okay, before playing the music, before clicking on this play button, first we will see the source code of this one. So as usual, HTML head, title, the closing title, then closing of head and body, and within the body there is some text that this page plays audio with controls, and the important one is the audio tag. See here, this one is the opening audio tag and this one is the closing audio tag. That means the pair tag and its closing is compulsory, and its first attribute is SRC, and values for this SRC is given here, that the file name instrumental mohabbate.mp3. That means when you click on this play button, it automatically start to play that file. Okay, so this one is the first attribute, that is SRC, which provides URL second attribute. The second attribute is controls. This controls attribute provide us a console, a standard console, by default a standard console. And a standard console include play button or pause button, seek bar, as well as a volume controls. If you see the syntax of this one, then simple syntax, that is the audio, and it's another, that the second attribute, that is the controls. So we'll see with example here that the controls, see, this one is the console, this one is the controls. This, the controls attribute provide this console to us, and this console contains the play button. When you click on this play button, then automatically it converts as a pause button. See, okay, so this one is the play or pause button. Second one, this one is the seek bar, and third one, this is the volume control. So controls give this console. If you see the source code here, see, within the body, this one is the audio tag. We required SRC, so SRC is the compulsory attribute while inserting or playing audio file on a web page, and it's another attribute, that is the controls. And these controls provide us this console. Okay, one important thing, that means by using these controls we can play audio file with control. Suppose you want to play a background music, that means play a music without controls, we need to insert its another attribute, that is the autoplay. We will discuss later. So this one is the controls attribute of audio tag. This one is the second one. If you see the third one is loop attribute. This loop attribute tells the browser to repeat the music continuously still the web page is opened. Okay, and the syntax for this is just simple, that the audio and loop attribute. Clear? If you see the example here, the audio loop attribute, actual the provided file is of 22 seconds, and when you click on this one, it continuously repeat the music. If we see once again its source code, see, within the body, the audio loop attributes, then the audio tag is used here, SRC is compulsory attribute, controls display the console, and the third one, important one, that is the loop attribute. Okay, and due to this loop attribute, we can play a music continuously still the file is opened, or still the user stop the music or pause the music. Okay, so this one is the loop attribute. Its another attribute is muted, and this muted attribute specifies the output should be mute. Okay, and the syntax for this one is audio just muted. If you see the example here, when you click, see here the console, here is a play button, there is a seek bar, and here is a volume control. But this volume control is muted. This volume control is muted due to its muted attribute. Okay, so here audio SRC equal to which audio file we want to play, this URL, then controls display the console, and the next one, that is the muted, and this muted attribute mute. When you click on play button, it start playing, but audio is muted. Still, when you click on this button, that means when you unmute, then automatically it starts playing. So this muted attribute, muted attribute, it's next, that the important one, that the autoplay attribute. This autoplay attribute, you are using this autoplay attribute, the audio file will start playing automatically when the web page is loaded in the web browser. okay, and the syntax for this one is a audio autoplay only. If you see the example here, first thing here, by default here in my PC, the Google Chrome is the default browser. The Google Chrome browser does not support this autoplay attribute. And to verify this, you need to open these contents in Microsoft Edge or in Internet Explorer. See here, autoplay in Microsoft Edge. It automatically starts. See first source. See here, the audio SRC equal to audio file. Controls, it display the console and that the autoplay. This autoplay attribute play the music automatically. Clear? So this one is the another important attribute. These are the main attributes of the audio tag. Okay. One important thing is here that audio tags, controls attribute, autoplay attribute, loop attribute and a muted attribute. That means only SRC is remaining. These four attributes are a Boolean attributes, and Boolean attributes means these four attribute does not have any value. So we can say that these attributes are Boolean attributes. Okay, so this one is the audio tag and their attributes. Now we'll see adding audios with multiple sources. Okay, that means we can provide multiple sources to the browser, and see here, multiple sources of audios are specified so that if the browser is unable to play the first source, then it will automatically jump to the second source. That means suppose one audio file format is not supported by the current browser, then it's not playing the audio files. At that time, you need to provide the same file with a different audio file format. At that time, we need to provide the multiple sources. And the browser will use the first recognized format. Another important thing that if the source file is .ogg extension file, then it will work in Firefox, it will work in Opera, it will work in Google Chrome and Microsoft Edge also. But when you want to open the file in the Internet Explorer or Safari browser, at that time this OGG file is not supported by this Internet Explorer and Safari. And suppose unfortunately we does not have any Google Chrome, Opera, Firefox and we have only Internet Explorer, Safari. At that time this OGG file is not supported, so our output or our audio file music will not be played. So we'll see with this example, the first one, that the first example we'll see this audio file format is first one we will see its source code. See the source code here. When you want to provide multiple sources, HTML provide this source tag instead of its SRC attribute. HTML 5.0 or 5 provide this source tag, and to the source its first attribute, that the SRC is given. But when you play this music here, here the .ogg file is here, ipl.ogg, okay, and when you come here and click on play button, it plays the music. Okay, but suppose we want to play this file in Internet Explorer browser. First thing, the Internet Explorer block these contents. Its ActiveX control block these contents. First we need to allow the blocked contents. After that, it provides the invalid source. If you see the its source code, see here, here also. Here, audio controls and source SRC equal to ipl.ogg. That means this OGG file is not supported in this Internet Explorer browser. Suppose we give the supported browsers. See here, second example. Second example open in Google Chrome. First we'll see here its source code. See here, it here provides two sources. The first one is, see here, first one is IPL.ogg, same file for same file but with the different file format, that the MP3. Okay, and when we open this file in our Internet Explorer browser, see here, the source is also displayed here. Source, first one is IPL.ogg. Already we discussed that the IPL.ogg does not support in Internet Explorer. So the second source is given here, that the IPL.mp3. And here, when you click on this one, automatically it's populated. That means the multiple sources provided. After providing the multiple sources, browser automatically shifts the recognized format. Okay, so this one is the benefit of the providing multiple sources. Clear? So this one is the audio on web page and audio tag in HTML 5.0. okay, so thank you students, thank you friends for watching my channel, for watching my this video. Our next video is of videos on a web page. So to keep learning, stay in touch. Thank you.